嗨，
那你在这个天呢？我是挺的，是，since you were young, there are a lot of things that and you were very mischievous when you were young. For example, every week she will go to a salon to do her hair. And once she's out of the door, my brother will take all the cosmetic, the little cooling mask that she has in the bottle, all the white clothes, and mix it with water, and then supposed to put it on. So my brother and I might play with that. Once she goes out of the house, we take one of those and then we start playing it around, make sure that she comes back, put it back. But my grandma, she's so organized. She will always remember where she put things or how are the things organized. And she will always know that we touch things. And yeah, we always get out of time. But my grandma was a very disciplined and strict person. She has a routine that she wants to follow, and because of that, I think I'm a bit of her right now. Not to say rigid, but I must say I'm a bit disciplined as well because of her. So she brought us up well. Yeah, that's how I remember. Always I would also help my cousins, Arthur and Esther, watching. This is from Esther. My grandmother was one of the people who I loved most in this world. So it sucks that I'm unable to say goodbye to her person. If you ask me to describe her in one word, it would be strong. My grandmother had it tough the past 2 years with deteriorating health and eyesight, but she always stood through and never gave up. One of the most extreme memories I have of her is when she had a favorite grandkid. Like a lot of grandmothers, the way she showed her was good. Say, remember what each of us tried to give, and we always try to give first. Every single time I visited her, I would leave the bag of frozen corn packets because she knew how much I liked it. My grandmother was there for every special occasion, so it's going to be hard not seeing her during Chinese New Year or Christmas, which is true. Mama, there are a lot of things I could not do for you and a lot of things I regret. I was very blessed to have a grandmother like you, and I always remember how blessed I was. Please know that I love you a lot and hope you enjoy love your grandmother. I have another one from Arthur. Mama, thank you for being incredibly selfless and loving. Words are inadequate to describe how much my family and I miss you. Thank you for your resilience in raising up my pa and Uma well and instilling in them the importance of family. Life wasn't always kind to you, but I can proudly say my life is a great one because of your sacrifices. Despite the language barrier, your love was always apparent to me. From sneakily passing me money so that my parents wouldn't see, and getting my favorite snacks and drinks during Chinese New Year, to always worrying and shipping money when I had to go to study. I'll especially miss you when you become a show. I'm sorry that in the past years, we haven't been able to see each other in person, and that I couldn't be there with you during the final days. I hope you pass knowing that I love you boundlessly, that I know how much you love me, and that you did everything you could to see me happy. I hope you are enjoying heaven, and it's always knowing that you will be in love your grandson. Anyone else? Would like to go to the stage. Love you. And I want to thank you so much. Sleepless night. And in fact, it's the day I woke a few times I couldn't sleep. I'm trying to think what I was going to sleep. Plus, my mind is really available, so I have to jot it down and write it down to them. Mom has always been a strong, independent person, and she is very, very particular to cleanliness and neatness, placing all her items in her house. Even if a piece of newspaper, you read it, you sew it properly in the next morning. And the fact is that she is a holder, but a neat one, a very neat one. She always does plastic all the things that she could use to make sure that doesn't fit. Mom, during her younger days, doesn't have to look like she looks like. And basically, she raised both me and my brother with her one home going through a very, very rough. For me, actually, from younger days, I have always come to sleep. And I can remember every time when she comes back, she was in this book. Every time she comes back, those days she stayed in those shop blocks, so Pan Street. If she is in the front, I walk back. If she is downstairs, I walk back. Because she always goes home. Why? Because I always dislike a very messy kind of child. And she is like, she wants to discipline me. And because maybe she's not close to me all the years, my relationship with my mom is always at all. It's only when I am in 12 months or 4 months, she got back to stay. And those days, I would say I'm not really at the same time because she was schooling. I don't know. But deep inside my heart, I know that she loves me, she loves my brother. Because being a mother, she has always, always loved children, kept for children. And I know that she is not the kind of passionate person who will hug you or say gentlemen. Never, I never got hugs from my mom. Never, my mom. Probably my brother does that because I think she loves my brother more. She always say, tell people, you know, if when you know that this my brother is one of the people from her. But I am the one who is taking the right to you. But I know mom, but I have never sort of like angry about this. I need to talk about the having friends. And mom has been very active. She has been like a community member in the Kapong Lantong where she also served the community in a way. And mom has served in the children in the street church, and she is known as the star of the home. I think she has enjoyed, you know, being the star of the home because she knows that she is so proud of being wanted by the children, and she is doing something that she needs to do. Well, the thing was so suddenly sort of like, I took a big hole in my heart. It's just a cold. But the woman is now in a place where she can rest in Jesus and praise, and that she will be having, you know, good days with Jesus Lord, and looking down upon us, blessing each one of us. Suffering in pain to come, but she will be like, she don't need fearful of going. And lastly, to Emma, You know, this is how we felt from this city on the last day, lying on the hospital bed. We sat beside your bed, right? Our hearts were crushed and sore. We did our duty to the end till we could not do no more. And in fears, in tears, we watched you simply. We watched you fade away. And though our hearts were bleeding, we know you could not stay. You left behind some aching hearts that love you most sincere. And we never, never shall, and never, never will forget you, but we loved you, and we always do.
Lady who has always been my grandmother of his children. But we know that we do not grieve as though there is hope. We are people that the scripture says that, you know, for us, there is yet hope and comfort in the knowledge that auntie is now in the Lord, in the Lord's presence, in the far end of the place, resting from the labors thereof. As we have heard from Susan earlier on, how the mother did in order to help support, raise the two of them. Friends, it is such a different time in the world today that we live in. A world that is full of uncertainties. Who would have thought that we would be living in what we can do, and why I don't know, except on the world right now. So, we need to be living in a world that is full of uncertainties, so that we can stay in the world around us, and we can have a lot of difficulties. Yet, I don't know, he said, in this uncertain world, there is something that is certain. It is that there is certain that we can come out of it. There's also two ways that we can do that. One is to choose to draw and try not to live with apology. Two, we can feel that so much that we are frozen still. We can't do anything at all. We don't do anything at all. Or three, we can accept the fact that when the time comes, we are prepared because we have a hope. The hope in Jesus, who we believe, who auntie to, had given a life to. Because the Bible says that we need to be prepared. We need to be having this hope that when the time comes, when that comes, we will be able to face it. Not with fear, but with courage, because we know that the hope of Jesus is realized on that day. So how do we all be there? Let's take a look at the scriptures, what it says about death. Psalmist 1 says, the precious is the sight of the Lord is the death of his godly ones. Why? What is it about this death that Christians, right, would say that they can look into the eyes of death because of the promise that the word of God says. Now, the passage that says, our brother just speaks about death as going to see it. This was a letter written by Paul to the people who were living in this city called Thessalonica in what is modern day Greece. In Thessalonica, the people were very gripped by the death that they had experienced among their people. And they were in deep grief. And Paul wrote that letter to encourage them that don't grieve if you need to be, but you are not the people who is without hope. You have people who have got hope. And he describes that death is just like an individual has gone to sleep. It is going to sleep. The very word that he saw in the message that was read three times, he emphasized this, that it is going to sleep. And in this concept about sleep, where did it come from? It was first mentioned by Jesus that the people had fallen asleep when they encountered death during one of his journey. Now, sleep to all of us, right, is something that we all say that we learn, right? Everybody learns. If they can sleep in an extra hour, right? Everybody loves it. They have a time that they could just sleep and not worry about what's going to happen to us, right? It is something that everyone looks forward to. But what is it about sleep? It is a time for us to rest, to renew whatever energy we have expended with about our daily activities. So, scripture says that death is not good to sleep. Material looks like she's asleep. So does anyone afraid of going to sleep? And death, the scripture says, is a time where we journey back to be reborn. Scripture teaches us that it is the time that we are reborn back to the presence of God. Jesus spoke about this whole time during one of the occasions to his disciples. When the disciples seek trouble, when he talked about that, it's the time that we come. But Jesus assured them with his words that he said, in response to the fear of death amongst his disciples, he says in John 14, verse 2, he says, I am going to prepare the place for you in my Father's house. That is the assurance Jesus gave, that you may know that when death comes, you have this hope and assurance that you will be returning to my Father's house, and in my Father's house, I have prepared a place for you. It's a place that we know that we would love. It's a place that we know that we can accept that we would be cared for in a very precious way. It is always an indescribable of goodness and joy to go back to our fathers and mothers' homes. I'm sure that you will all have memories about the time of returning to your mom's home, or your grandmother's home, during the festive seasons like Chinese New Year, or perhaps some people who also gather for the mid-autumn festivals, or even at the winter solstice festival. Those are precious memories because why? As some of you described, grandma would be born. My favorite. Grandma will make sure that I get my favorite snacks. Grandma will make sure that, you know, whatever she has prepared, you know, it is something special for everyone in the family. So we feel good. That's why returning to the Father's house, where Jesus has prepared a room, gives the hope to all believers. Heaven is just like that. It is going home to a place where we know we will be loved. It is a place where we will be at peace and at rest. So what therefore is it for believers about death? We don't need to fear death. Those who believe has no need to fear death because they have that promise. Friends, the Bible is very clear that the only way back to the Father's house is through Jesus. Jesus Christ is one and only Son. Jesus is the way. He has declared, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So Jesus, through his death at the cross at Calvary and his resurrection on the 20th, have defeated death. That we can now all stand in the face of death and say, where in death is your state? Where in death is your state? We will receive a new body, Christ, and live forever with him. That's the promise that the Bible is given to us. So, for those who have yet to know Jesus, may I invite you today to trust in him as your Lord and Master Savior. The scripture says in John 3:16, that for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And what is that eternal life? It's that eternal life that I will make unto you as carried. It is that eternal life because Jesus has promised, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. Whoever lives and believes in me will never die. So do you believe in you too? And this promise that to all who receive it, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. This is Jesus. Isn't it fantastic? Isn't it wonderful to be called children of God? Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, you are a God of comfort and spirit. We do not pretend today that we do not grieve, for you know the agony of grief, and we do grieve, God. But we do not grieve as those who have gone home, for we know that is grateful. Our hope is assurance of eternal life with you, only because of the finished work of Jesus on the cross. So, our Heavenly Father, we call this time of pain and loss to bring comfort and hope to those who you love. We ask this not because we are deserving, but because you are a God of us in grace and comfort. So, God, make your strength this time. And in turn, we shall praise. We ask this above all other needs, the need that has conquered them, the very need of Jesus. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor Samuel, brother, who lead us in keep.
For the hymn of Christian song number 8, the hymn number 8. In the sweet by and by. There's a land that is fairer than me, and my faith we can see it afar. For the Father is to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the dream, by and far, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the dream, by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the band. The voices we shall pour on the for a time in the passing of death, in the spring, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the spring, by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. In the spring, by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore. In the spring, by goes to prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, as we stand in your presence, we bring before you our dear sister Susan and our brothers and sisters, and our parents. Lord, you recognize us. You see your God in heaven. But we pray, God, that through you, O God, the Spirit of us will be comforted, that it will find strength because of the hope of Jesus. We pray, O Lord, that this time that you grant them peace, comfort, and assurance of the presence of Jesus' name.
Amen.
All right. Just a quick announcement. I'll still get from tomorrow. Those friends and relatives who like to be the last respect, they are not to come here from between 10 a.m. and 7 p.m. So I guess they will need the number of people to check on the council. And I think they will be numbering back to the group. So those who like to be there with last perspective, because of the year, come tomorrow at 10 a.m. and 7 p.m. And tomorrow there will be another wake service at 4 p.m. And then on Wednesday, we will have the
I'm
Questa giornata.
Wow, tá bom.